Hello all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll be talking about Oracle data conversion. So generally, data conversion happens whenever you go for a fresh implementation of Oracle ERP. So you need to extract the data from the legacy system and then upload that into Oracle. So there are different steps involved in a data conversion. So the first thing is the conversion of the closing balance data as on of a cutoff date in a form of a journals in Oracle General Ledger. So that is, you need to extract the trial balance from the legacy system and upload the trial balance as a maybe a Webedia journal in general ledger. And then the second step is conversion of the open transactions, that is uploading of the open transactions as on cutoff date into Oracle subledgers like your accounts payable, accounts receivable, fixed assets, purchasing, and inventory. And the last step is importing of those subledger module data into Oracle general ledger and then reversing of those entries in GL. Now I'll explain in detail as to how we can execute these steps. Of course, I will not be able to show that these in the system because I need to have a fresh instance with no data, which I do not have now. So that's the reason I'll explain all these steps in a spreadsheet. So in general, so these are the different data conversion items. So the first thing is your supplier site master and the open AP invoices, debit memos, credit memos, and the prepayments to suppliers. And as far as the AR is concerned, customer master and customer sites. And as far as the transactional data is concerned, open customer invoices, debit memos, credit memos, and unapplied receipts. As far as the cash management is concerned, bank master and the open bank statement lines. And fixed assets balances, purchasing, open purchase order, and the PO or you can call it as a HR is the employee master. And as far as the inventory is concerned, item master and the opening balances, which is both quantity and price. And as far as GLA is concerned, your account balances and your chart of account segment values. So as far as the data conversion of all these items are concerned, either you can use your front end data entry or wherever possible, you can go for WebADA or you can use your data loader tool. And if any of these things are not available, you can go for your using your standard or custom interfaces or APIs. So the first thing is you need to get your trial balance from the client's legacy system and upload that particular trial balance in Oracle GL as a WebADA journal. So let us assume that this is how your trial balance looks like. So let us assume that this is a simple trial balance wherein you have a cash account balance of say 10,000, accounts receivable 25,000, unapplied receipts 10,000, revenue, expense, AP liability, AP prepayments, inventory, retained earnings, share capital, deposits, loans, asset cost, accumulated depreciation, unapplied receipts, and so on. So your trial balance should be balance. So ensure that before you load your trial balance in Oracle, ensure that the trial balance, whatever is provided to you by the client, is balanced. Ideally, it should be balanced whenever they are extracting that from their legacy system. But just in case, you should ensure that it's balanced. That is, your debits and credits are matching. Once the trial balance is uploaded in general ledger, then you need to go for uploading of the open transactions in the subledger. In general, you generally upload only open transactions. You do not go for historical transactions. If you want to go for historical upload of the historical transactions into the subledger, then the approach will be a bit different. In my current video, my assumption is that we are going for uploading of only open transactions. So as far as the open transactions is concerned, so first we'll talk about AP. So it could be your invoices, debit memos, credit memos, and prepayments. So when you upload your invoices in subledger, so this is how your journal entry will be created. Your AP charge account will be debited and your AP liability account will be credited. And when you upload your debit memos and credit memos, your AP liability will be debited and AP charge account will be credited. And if you observe here, the net impact of your AP liability is $15,000. So if you observe in your GL trial balance, your AP liability account shows $15,000. So that means the breakup of this $15,000 needs to be entered in the your subledger. Otherwise, you will have a reconciliation issues. Similarly, for the prepayment is concerned, here you can see the prepayment balance is 11,000. So your AP prepayment, which are created in the subledger, should be for 11,000. So when you create your AP prepayment, the general entry will be your AP prepayment account will be debited and your AP liability account will be credited. And of course, your whenever you create your prepayment, the prepayment will be in unvalidated status. In order for this particular prepayment to be available for any other open invoices, you need to actually make a payment of this prepayment. So you need to maybe make a payment of this particular prepayment using a kind of a dummy bank account. When you make a payment, the general entry will be your AP liability account will be debited and bank account will be credited. So once this activity is completed, that is opening of the uploading of the transactions in the subledger is concerned, you need to run create accounting program, transfer to GL, and then these entries will be transferred to general ledger. Once these entries are transferred to general ledger, you should ensure that these general entries are reversed in GL. The reason why we are reversing in GL is in GL we have already uploaded the trial balance, so the accounting impact is already available in GL, and hence run create accounting in subledger, transfer to GL, and then hang on, we charge my laptop. Sorry. Okay, so once the create accounting is run, the entries will be transferred to GL, and in GL you need to reverse those accounting entries. And once the accounting entries are reversed in GL, so in GL you have these original entries and then you reverse these entries in GL. So the net impact is in GL is the balances, whatever is already uploaded in GL as part of your WebADA trial balance upload. And when you run your any reports in your subledger, so take an example, if you run your accounts payable trial balance report in subledger, the accounts payable trial balance report in subledger, so in this case will show a balance of $15,000. And when you try to compare with your general ledger, it will be matching with your general ledger. So in general ledger you have $15,000, and you are in AP when you run your accounts payable trial balance, it will show $15,000. So that's how you should be able to match your subledger and GL. And remember, when you want to reverse these subledger general entries in GL, you should unfreeze the journal source, because in R12, if you generally these subledger journal sources are in a frozen status, you need to unfreeze that. Then only system will allow you to reverse those journal entry. And once the journal entries are reversed, you need to again freeze the journal source back. So that this is how you upload the open transactions in the subledger, run create accounting, transfer to GL, and reverse those entries in GL. So similarly, you need to do exactly the same case with the other subledgers. So now, coming back to AR. In AR, we may have your invoices, debit memos, credit memos, and there could be, say, even unapplied receipts. So again, whenever you load your invoices or debit memos in AR, your general entry will be receivable account will be debited and revenue account will be credited. And if you upload your credit memos, your revenue account will be debited and receivable account will be credited. And the general entry for the open unapplied receipts would be a bank account will be debited, unapplied receipts will be created. Again, run create accounting, the original entries will be transferred to GL, unfreeze the journal source, reverse this accounting entry, and again freeze the journal source back. So again, when you run your AR report, so take an example, say aging report, it will show a balance of, in this case, say $25,000 under in your receivable account, which should be exactly matching with the balance whatever is there is in your GL. Because in GL, as you are already reversed the journal entry which has come from the subledger, the only balance left in GL will be $25,000. So this is how your subledger and your GL balance should match. Similarly, for the fixed assets, when you upload your fixed assets either using your WebADA or through your mass additions, the accounting entry will be asset cost account will be debited and asset clearing account will be credited and transfer it to run create accounting, transfer it to GL, and then reverse this particular entry. Remember, as far as the asset are concerned, when you are uploading these assets, ensure that you upload your asset cost along with your accumulated depreciation so that the net book value, so that system will start calculating your concerned depreciation on these assets based on the your net book value of the asset. So here your asset cost is say $33,000, and the general entry is asset cost debit, asset clearing account credit. If you go to your GL trial balance, this is the asset cost and this is the accumulated depreciation. So in this scenario, the system will not create any accounting entry for the accumulated depreciation. But when you start running the depreciation from the post conversion period onwards, system should ideally calculate depreciation on 33,000 minus 13,000, which is 20,000. The net book value of the asset is 20,000. So system should ideally calculate depreciation on $20,000, provided you are using your return on value method. Similarly, as far as the cash management is concerned, you enter your bank statement lines either manually or through an interface. And as there are no accounting entries are generated for the bank statement lines, so no reversal is required in GL. And there are two more items which I'm not going in detail. One is the purchasing and other is inventory. As far as the purchase orders are concerned, upload your open purchase orders. When I say open purchase orders to the extent where the quantity is not received. So upload your open purchase order, that is purchase order to the extent of the quantity which is not received in your purchasing. And again, for the purchase orders, there are no accounting entries which are created in the system, and hence no create accounting, transfer to GL or reversal is required in GL. And as far as the inventory is concerned, yes, you need to upload your on-hand quantity. So for that, you can go for, say, miscellaneous receipt transaction in inventory. Through your miscellaneous receipt transaction in inventory, the accounting entry will be your inventory material valuation account will be debited, and the account whatever you specify when you are creating your miscellaneous receipt transaction will be credited. Again, run create accounting, transfer to GL, and then reverse that particular accounting entry. So the net impact is you have an on-hand quantity in inventory and there is no financial impact in GL because you have already reversed that particular accounting entry in GL. So at a high level, this is how you go for your data conversion in any live environment. But of course, there could be a lot of other challenges wherein if the customer says that they want to go for upload of historical transactions and maybe various other items other than the items whatever has mentioned in this paper, data conversion items. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video, for interesting videos on Oracle Financials. Please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.